I am very much thankful to you for calling me over for this this discourse. Rather, this is a new generation seminar which are going on right now, and Devendra is quite capable of handling this type of seminar, and I think he will be able to answer all of your queries in respect of the appeal module which we introduced. As you all of you know that the automation has been in various phases. We started with the ACP automation, and immediately afterwards the GST was implemented. So accordingly, we had to go for the GST automation also. Now, amongst all these sorts of things, the development of ACP modules was a big challenge, and we are actually presently in a very comfortable position because of the various modules which we developed in automation, as far as the old VAT law is concerned. And subsequently, you have now seen that the GST automation at the national platform is quite a resolved automation system. So with this, I just don't want to take much of time, and let us go ahead with the seminar. I'll be here for some time, and I will have to leave the meeting for some other meeting, and then I will again join, say, about 15 minutes before the end of the session. So kindly excuse me for that. My best wishes to GSTPM, all the office bearers, all the members, and I'm really thankful to you for the support you have been giving to the department in respect of the various functionalities. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Now I would request Devendra Sinha sir to take the charge.
Thank you, Dinesh ji. I am audible to all?
Yes, yes.
Okay. I request everyone to zoom auto, please unmute the mic. Otherwise, the host can unmute the members also. First, I would like to thank the officials and the members of GSTPM Association for conducting this much awaited GST mega guidance sale on this appeal module. Appeal module has been rolled out in the month of December 2019. Since that, we have been trying to conduct this seminar, but due to some or other unforeseen events, we could not able to conduct that. But hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir. You
now it has been conducted. So we'll start the presentation. As told by Mr. Dinesh Tambade, that the presentation that the seminar will be divided in the three parts. First part will be the presentation of the appeal module. I will give the brief idea how this module has been designed, what are the basic parameters while designing this module, and how it is integrated with other modules which are available on SAP system. Then in the second part, we'll go through the demo of one or two test cases on the dealer portal. And in the third part, I will try to answer the queries which has been communicated to me yesterday night by Mr. Sunil Joshi. Also, if time permits, we'll try to address some more queries which are being uploaded by the members on this chat room. If any query remains to be answered or any issue remains to be resolved, we can highlight that, and we can try it to be resolved afterwards. What we are planning to do is that yesterday also we had discussed about it. We'll try to frame the DDP.
Shinde sahab, tumse unmute kara please. Hello, Devendra Shinde sir, tumse unmute kara please.
Maza unmute sahe. Based on the queries which are
yes, kill
video off kara please sagyani shakya asel tar please other than speaker ani host please video off kara sagyani
okay See, this is new system. This is virtual mega guidance cell. So it is quite natural that some technical hindrances will may appear. So we'll try to do as much as possible. What we are planning to do is that yesterday also I had discussed that with the officials of the GSTPM Association. We'll try to frame the frequently asked questions. Vinoji, can you identify? There is particularly one member whose mic is on, I think. Please try to identify that and unmute that member. We'll try to design the FAQs based on the queries received. I had received yesterday also, and based on the queries which are being uploaded by the members, and we'll also try to answer that all the queries in that FAQs. Now I will start the presentation. सर्वांना व्हिडिओ दिसतोय का? स्क्रीन दिसतेय का?
हो दिसतेय सर.
यस यस यस.
ओके ओके. या प्रेझेंटेशन मध्ये इन दिस प्रेझेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द सम ऑफ द टॉपिक्स विच आर इंट्रोडक्शन टू द अपील मॉड्यूल. वॉट आर द डीलर एंड एप्लीकेशन्स दॅट दोज आर बीइंग अवेलेबल फॉर द डीलर्स टू बी फाइल्ड ऑन अपील मॉड्यूल. वॉट आर द ऑफिसर एंड ऑर्डर्स द अपिलेट ऑफिसर विल बी एबल टू पास ऑन SAP सिस्टीम. वॉट आर द प्रोसिजरल चेंजेस which are being amended after 15th April 2007. उसके बाद हम लोग डीलर लॉग इन कैसे और अपील एप्लीकेशन फाइल करते समय डीलर लॉग इन कहाँ पे करता है वो भी देखेंगे. टाइप ऑफ स्टे अवेलेबल कौन से है वैट और CST में वो भी देखेंगे. वॉट इज द केस अलोकेशन लॉजिक एंड अदर डिपेंडेंसीज विल ऑल्सो गो थ्रू दैट अदर एंड वॉट इज द करंट स्टेटस ऑफ द अपील मॉड्यूल विल गिव अ ब्रीफ फिगर्स अबाउट दैट. हमें सबको पता है कि इसके पहले बिफोर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस ऑनलाइन अपील मॉड्यूल अपील जो भी कुछ फाइल होते थे सब मैन्युअली होते थे. सिंस 2005 जब से वैट का इंट्रोडक्शन हुआ था आफ्टर दैट अंटिल 2019 तो ऑल अपील्स वर बीइंग फाइल्ड ऑन मैन्युअल बेसिस. फिजिकली सब लोग अपीलेट ऑफिसर को अपील फाइल करते थे बट नाउ दिस सिस्टम हैज बीन चेंज. सो ऑलमोस्ट 14-15 ईयर्स का जो मैनुअल अपील्स फाइल होते थे वो सिस्टम हम लोग ने डिसम्बर 2019 में चेंज करने का ट्राई किया है. अपील इज एज वी ऑल नो इट इज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर ओनली पासिंग ऑफ सम रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑर्डर और असेसमेंट ऑर्डर. उसके बाद कोई भी अपील फाइल करते हैं तो उसका अपील ऑर्डर होता है. अपील मॉड्यूल में जब डीलर कोई लॉग इन करता है आफ्टर लॉगिंग दैट वेन द डीलर सक्सेसफुली फाइल्स द अपील एप्लीकेशन द सिस्टम जनरेटेड अपील एक्नोलेजमेंट नंबर इज जनरेटेड and that triggers the appeal case. As soon as the appeal case is created that starts visible on the officer desk. Wo kaise hota hai wo bhi main dikhaunga. As we all know that appeal process triggers from filing of appeal application. The appeal proceeding may end up by issuing various other orders like summary rejection order, demand back order, appeal dismissal order, appeal withdrawal order or final appeal order whatever may be. So we had to overcome many functionalities which are being manually passed by the appellate officer aur usko sab ko hum log ne club karke appeal module mein inka cover karne ka try kiya. How that is going to be wo main aapko baad mein ye karta hu. Dealer and applications appeal module mein kon kon se available hai. So you can see the list of the applications which are available on dealer portal to be filed online. First is the appeal application form 310 under VAT Act. Second is appeal application form 9B under CST Act. If the appeal is filed for the order passed before 15-4-2017, to uske liye, as we all know, uske liye form 310 ke saath form 311 bhi bharna tha. To wo form 311 is for application for stay. वो भी सिस्टम पे अवेलेबल है. सिस्टम ऑटोमेटिकली आइडेंटिफाइज द डेट ऑफ द ऑर्डर बेस्ड ऑन दैट सिस्टम ऑटोमेटिकली शोज फॉर्म 311 if it is applicable to the dealer to be filed. As we all know, ki, after 60 days of receipt of assessment order, if the dealer comes to file the appeal, he has to file the delay condonation application. So, wo bhi system identify karti hai based on the service date of the order, which is available on the system, and accordingly, it shows the delay condonation application to be filed by the dealer. It is also available on dealer portal. Appeal withdrawal application, once the appeal application is filed, the dealer can file the appeal withdrawal application. As we all know, amnesty scheme was being introduced by the department. To uske liye dealer ko appeal withdrawal application file karna tha, ya fir other circumstances, if dealer wish to withdraw the appeal, then also that appeal withdrawal application is available on the system. Then restoration application for summary rejection order or for appeal dismissal order, it is also available on the system. This is the first, earlier slide was for from the dealer end. So now you can see the slide for officer end orders. There are various orders which are being passed by the appellate officer based on the facts of the case or merit of the case. It is not necessary that in each and every case all these appeal orders may be passed, but in certain isolated cases some of this order may be passed. In certain other cases some of other orders may be passed. So you can see the list of all the orders. This interim stay cum part payment order that was applicable before 15/4/2017, if the application is filed for the orders which are passed before 15/4/2017, then this facility of passing part payment order is available to the appellate officer on officer portal. Final stay order, as you all know, it is in form 312, that is also available. Then delay condonation order is available, summary rejection order is available, appeal dismissal order is available, appeal remand back order is also available on the system. Appeal withdrawal application based on the appeal withdrawal order based on the appeal withdrawal application is also available. Additional part payment order, if officer is required to pass if any additional part payment order, then also it is available in form 319. Then stay continuation or stay vacation order, and then finally is appeal order. All these orders are available on the officer portal to be passed online. There are certain officers who has passed already the final stay order on the module. The dealer may have received those order on their registered mail ID, or they can see that order on dealer portal also. This slide is regarding the procedural changes. We all very well aware about the procedural changes that was carried out after 15/4/2017 by the amendment in Maharashtra Act. So उसके पहले जो अपील एप्लीकेशन होते थे उसमें एड एंट्रीम स्टे देन एंट्रीम स्टे देन पार्ट पेमेंट ऑर्डर इफ द डीलर पेज द पार्ट पेमेंट ऑर्डर देन फाइनल स्टे ऑर्डर ये सब प्रोसीजर होता था. सो वी ऑल नो कि उसमें बहुत डीलर का भी और ऑफिसर का भी बहुत टाइम कंजम्पशन होता था. सो बाद में ये प्रोसीजर चेंज होने के बाद गवर्नमेंट हैज मेड मैंडेटरी पार्ट पेमेंट प्रोविजन. And after paying that part payment amount, then only the officer issues the final stay order. By this amendment also, remand back provisions has been introduced. Compulsory part payment ka bhi ye kiya hai. And after this provision, the discretion available to the appellate officer for deciding the part payment was withdrawn. And there is now no discretion for the appellate officer to decide the part payment. Now we'll come to the you can see the slide. Now it is with respect to the actual appeal model technical issues. Isme jo appeal application file karne ke hai usme three gateways diye hai. Jaise Shaigram sir ne bhi bataya ki hum log ka SAP ka jo assessment orders hota hai uske against jo appeal file hote hai, that was very easy for us to design that application, because that system data is available for assessment order which are passed on SAP system. But there are many cases where the dealer wish to file the appeal against the order which is passed on Mahavikas system or say physical orders. So we had to design the second gateway for the purpose of these Mahavikas orders which are not available on SAP system. So the second gateway is with respect to this non-SAP orders. So any kind of demand order which is not available on SAP system can be filed, the dealer can file the appeal against these orders also. How this appeal is filed, wo sab hamare appeal manual mein sab elaborately mention kiya hua hai. third type is miscellaneous appeals. If the registration of the dealer is cancelled by the registration officer or say nodal officer, the dealer can file the appeal against this registration cancellation order by going into the miscellaneous appeal tab. Few days before, I had received a call from commissioner office that the STP association has communicated to the commissioner office that the registration appeal application against the registration orders cannot be filed on the system. So I want to communicate regarding this, that already 27 appeal applications against the registration orders are filed. Almost 68 dealers had actually filled up that application, but after payment gateway they didn't pay the appeal fees. So unka stop kiya wo dealer ne Sumoto. Otherwise 27 appeal application both for VAT and CST registration cancellation orders are filed by the dealers. Now this you can see the slide that how that appeal module is integrated with other modules. So it is like a structured design. Appeal module में dealer का जो registration का data है, so for example TIN number of the dealer or address of the dealer, PAN number or whatever other details available in registration master data is fetched from that registration master data and it is shown to the dealer from dealer portal. Then after carrying out assessment, how it is related to assessment module, the assessment orders are when it is passed on SAP system or say non-SAP system, that assessment module data, if it is passed on SAP system, that as per assessment ka column jo hai dealer portal pe, usme wo auto fetch hoke, auto populate hoke wo data wahan pe fetch hota hai, jisme dealer ko wo first column bhanne ka kuch bhi zarurat nahi rehta hai. As far as this manually passed on non-SAP orders, that as per assessment column is left blank to filed by the dealers because that data is not available on SAP system. So dealer can file that as per assessment order column and then subsequently file the appeal application. Assessment module mein assessing officer ne jo assessment orders ka jo form bhara hai, uske baad usko assessment order system pe service karna padta hai aur wo order service date system pe update karna padta hai. So that system service date and order service confirmed date, whatever is updated by the assessing officer is picked by the appeal module and accordingly it shows in the appeal application also. If that appeal application is filed after 60 days of that service of order date, then the appeal module automatically shows delay condonation application to be filed by the dealer. So that is how it is linked with the assessment module. As and when assessment order is serviced on the dealer, either from SAP system or it is whenever it is uploaded updated by the assessing officer on the SAP system, that amount, that assessment order dues automatically transfers into the recovery module. So as and when that recovery dues are transferred into the recovery module, when the dealer files the any appeal application, system identifies that line item against which that appeal application is filed based on that assessment number, assessment order ID. So assessment order ID is also linked with recovery module and appeal module also. So as and when dealer files the appeal application, that system identifies the assessment order ID and that bifurcates those dues into available dues and not available dues based on the application filed by the dealer. As and when the appellate officer, if say he files, he orders the summary rejection order or any appeal order, to uska effect bhi automatically system se trigger hote, recovery module mein automatically reflect hota hai. If the dues are reduced by the appellate officer accordingly, that relief granted amount is posted in the dealer ledger accordingly, recovery ke dues wo kamti ho jate hain. If dues are added by the appellate officer, then dues added mein uska liability ledger mein add ho jata hai aur recovery module mein bhi uska reflect ho jata hai. So that is how it is related with recovery module. Then how it is related with payment module? कोई भी appeal application जब भी file करता है, तो appeal application के साथ उसको जो appeal का part payment या फिर appeal fees भरना होता है, तो उसके लिए वहाँ पे एक tab दिया है payment module के लिए, proceed for payment का. तो once the dealer clicks that tab, then he moves from appeal module to payment module. और payment module में जाके वो appeal application का जो accordingly part payment और appeal fees जो है, वो determine किया वो payment करता है. आफ्टर पेइंग दैट सक्सेसफुल पेमेंट जब भी ट्रिगर होता है सिस्टम में तभी वो रिकवरी मॉड्यूल से वापस इंटीग्रेट होता है एंड वॉट एवर ड्यूज वॉट एवर पार्ट पेमेंट पेड बाय द डीलर दैट इज ऑल्सो रिफ्लेक्टेड इन रिकवरी मॉड्यूल उसका रिकवरी उतने अमाउंट से कमती हो जाता है और उतने अमाउंट से जब भी अपीलेट ऑफिसर कोई स्टे ऑर्डर वगैरह करता है तो अकॉर्डिंगली उसका वहां पे रिकवरी और पेमेंट मॉड्यूल में ट्रिगर चला जाता है सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज इंटीग्रेटेड विथ रजिस्ट्रेशन असेसमेंट रिकवरी एंड पेमेंट मॉड्यूल देर आर मेनी अदर मॉड्यूल्स टू विच अपील मॉड्यूल इज ऑल्सो रिलेटेड बट दैट इज नॉट इट इज उसमें कुछ मेजर नहीं है बताने लायक ये चार मॉड्यूल का था सो वी हैड टू टेक इन टू कंसिडरेशन ऑल द पॉसिबिलिटीज एंड इवेंचुअलिटीज एंड सीनारियोज ऑफ दिस रजिस्ट्रेशन असेसमेंट रिकवरी पेमेंट मॉड्यूल वहां पे कौन सी फंक्शनलिटी अवेलेबल है कौन से नहीं वहां पे डीलर का पेमेंट कैसे होता है एंड अकॉर्डिंगली वी हैड टू डिजाइन द अपील एप्लीकेशन एंड द फर्दर गेटवेज ये जो स्लाइड है यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं डीलर लॉग इन कैसे होता है और फाइलिंग ऑफ अपील एप्लीकेशन कैसे होता है एक्चुअली आई एम गोइंग टू शो द डेमो ऑफ दिस थिंग सो विल स्किप दिस स्लाइड इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी इट आफ्टरवर्ड्स ये दोनों स्लाइड वैसे ही है देन दिस टाइप ऑफ स्टे अवेलेबल में यू कैन वी ऑल आर अवेयर दैट आफ्टर 15/4/2017 only final stay final stay is available to be filed by the dealers option of final stay is available but we have also introduced the auto stay option or system generated final stay option it is not mandatory to be selected by the dealer obviously they can go for final stay but the dealer if wish to pay the undisputed dues or accepted dues along with the appeal application also he can opt for that auto stay option other than this order passed on or after 15/4/2017 the system automatically shows the option of add interim stay to the dealer cst may be same hai usme kuch difference nahi hai now this case allocation logic and other dependencies we all know that particular assessing officer ka appeal kiske paas file hona chahiye there is some logic behind that. Accordingly, notifications were issued by the department. Ki LTU for example, LTU1 ke jitne bhi appeals hai, LTU1 ke deputy commissioner jitne bhi assessment order karte, uske appeal F001 CST APP F001 karke desk hai, file honi chahiye. Sub nodal officer ke particular appellate officer designated hai, to whom the appeal is required to be filed. Here, what was happening that जो डीलर है या फिर एसटीपी है या फिर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट है उनको वो पता नहीं चल रहा था कि ये कौन से अपीलेट डेस्क के पास ये अपील जाना है ओके सो अर्लियर वी हैड गिवन द प्रोविजन टू एंटर द अपीलेट ऑफिसर डेस्क इन द अपील एप्लीकेशन देन वी रिसीव्ड सम इनपुट्स फ्रॉम द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स और एसोसिएशन और फ्रॉम डीलर्स देन वी मेंटेन्ड अ टेबल इन द सिस्टम इटसेल्फ दैट As per the assessment order desk, assessing officer desk, we had maintained that table in the system itself so that the dealer is not required to find to whom the appeal is required to be, to which desk the appeal is required to be filed. Now that based on the assessing officer desk, the system automatically identifies the appellate officer desk and it automatically pops up over there. And accordingly, whenever the dealer files the appeal, that as per the system logic, the appeal application is automatically allocated to that particular appellate officer. Dealer is not required to enter the desk. Dealer is not required to find the desk to whom the appeal application is required to be filed now. So what is the current status of appeal? So yesterday only we had faced the data that as on Tuesday, almost 13,094 appeal applications were filed by the dealer on system and almost 20 crore 94 lakhs part payment was paid by the dealers on the system so even in the period of lockdown we had received almost 4 to 5 appeal applications on online system per day So this is how the appeal module has been designed. Now we'll move on to the some of the test cases for dummy teams we had generated. I had to connect to VPN because अदरवाइज लैंड पेज अभी हम लोग ये करते तो दिस सॉफ्टवेयर इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू बी यूज्ड बट आई एम वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम सो आई हैड टू कनेक्ट टू वीपीएन एंड देन गो टू द वेबसाइट ये जो फर्स्ट केस में दिखा रहा हूँ वो क्वालिटी सर्वर पे है दैट इज नॉट एक्चुअली द डीलर पोर्टल सो इसमें मैं पेमेंट वगैरह एक्चुअली नहीं करूँगा लेकिन पेमेंट टैप तक कैसे जाते हैं वो भी दिखाता हूँ और दिनेश सर ने जो स्टार्टिंग में एक क्यूरी बताया था कि इसमें सेव का ऑप्शन नहीं है तो सेव का ऑप्शन है इसमें दैट आई विल ऑल्सो शो दैट ऑप्शन हाउ इट इज अवेलेबल और देयर तो डीलर पोर्टल पे लॉगिन होने के बाद यहाँ पे मुझे ये अपील एप्लीकेशन स्क्रीन दिखता है उस अपील एप्लीकेशन में सर्च ऑर्डर और डॉक्यूमेंट नंबर का फर्स्ट रो है उसके बाद नीचे सर्च के अलग अलग ऑप्शंस दिए इफ द डीलर और सीए और एसटीपी नोज द नंबर ऑफ असेसमेंट ऑर्डर आईडी अगर उसको पता है तो वो डायरेक्टली यहाँ पे इनकॉर्पोरेट कर सकता है डाल सकता है अगर पता नहीं तो उसको सर्च कैसे कर सकते हैं वो भी मैं दिखाता हूँ नाउ आई एम इन रिसीट ऑफ दिस असेसमेंट ऑर्डर 73134 अगर कोई एसएपी पे असेसमेंट ऑर्डर पास होता है तो कंपल्सरीली उसका सिस्टम जनरेटेड ऑर्डर आईडी क्रिएट होता है दैट ऑर्डर आईडी इज यू कैन सी दैट ऑर्डर आईडी ऑन द बार कोड विच इज जो ऑर्डर आपको सर्विस होता है वहां पे बार कोड रहता है उस पे वो बार कोड पे जो नंबर रहता है दैट इज असेसमेंट ऑर्डर आईडी ऑल्सो द रेफरेंस आईडी जहां पे फर्स्ट पेज ऑफ असेसमेंट ऑर्डर है वहां पे भी वो असेसमेंट ऑर्डर आईडी रिफ्लेक्ट होता है ओके एज आई नो द ऑर्डर नंबर आई एम पेस्टिंग दिस ऑर्डर नंबर देन आई एम क्लिकिंग द डिस्प्ले ऑप्शन नाउ यू कैन सी दैट आफ्टर क्लिकिंग दिस डिस्प्ले ऑप्शन थ्री टैब्स हैव अपीयर्ड ओवर हियर First is appeal application and part payment, rectification and payment. यहाँ पे जो assessment order ID जो system से मुझे service हुआ है वो order ID भी आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे मुझे दिख रहा है वो सब order ID. as this order is issued on SAP system and it is also served on SAP system, iske liye main ye mujhe order ID dikh raha hai. Now yesterday Mr. Sunil Joshi had communicated to certain issues that we cannot see the order which is serviced on us by the officer wagara wagara. So what certain times what happens is that assessing officers pass the orders on SAP system. They take the printout of the order, they digitally sign it, and they after digitally signing it take the printout of the order and manually service that order to the dealer. But he sometimes does not service the order on SAP system. Usko SAP system mein order service karne ke liye provision hai. So usko SAP system pe order service karne par isko yahan pe automatically dealer ko ye screen pe order ID search karenge to usko ye screen pe ye order mil jata hai. And that appeal application and part payment tab is also visible to the dealer. Where the assessment order is not serviced on SAP system, उसमें उसको डीलर को ये अपील एप्लीकेशन एंड पार्ट पेमेंट का टैब यहाँ पे दिखता नहीं है. तो उसके लिए डिपार्टमेंट हैज कैरिड आउट एक्सटेंसिवली सर्टेन फील्ड लेवल मेजर्स सिंस द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रुवरी, बट ड्यू टू अनफॉर्चुनेट लॉकडाउन आफ्टर मार्च उसमें थोड़ा सा हिंड्रेंस है. बट अदरवाइज दैट ऑल द ऑर्डर्स विच आर पास्ड ऑन एसीपी सिस्टम ऑफिसर को ऐसे इंस्ट्रक्शन दिए गए हैं कि सब ऑर्डर सिस्टम पे सर्विस भी होना चाहिए. सो दैट वर्क इज इन प्रोग्रेस एंड होपफुली विद इन से 15 डेज और सो डीलर विल नॉट फेस दिस इशू दैट द ऑर्डर इज नॉट विजिबल ऑन एसएपी सिस्टम और द अपील एप्लीकेशन टैब इज नॉट विजिबल ऑन एसएपी सिस्टम. सो दिस इज फॉर द ऑर्डर्स विच आर द ऑर्डर नंबर इज अवेलेबल विथ मी. नाउ से आई डोंट हैव दैट ऑर्डर नंबर विथ मी, देन आई कैन गो टू सर्च ऑप्शन. I can select the act. What is the document type? That is the assessment order. So I am selecting the assessment order. For which period the assessment order is passed? I have to select that period. You can use the search option if the order is not order number is not available with you. If the order number is available, you can directly enter that order number and click on display button. So this assessment order is passed for 2012. So I am selecting the period. After entering the search parameters, I am clicking the submit button. So yahan pe submit hone ke baad, you can see that there are two orders passed for this particular period. You can see the order number against which that against these periods. To mujhe kaun sa order number ke against appeal file karna hai wo mujhe order open karne par pata chal jayega. So it is 73134. I think the period is different for this. Just a minute. It is for 8-9. Okay, I am entering the period now. I have entered wrong period. 8. I am again clicking the submit option. Now you can see that order number and this act, issue date, period from period to all these things are available with me. Now I can click on this order number. जो पहले मैंने ऑर्डर नंबर डाल के डिस्प्ले जो क्लिक किया था वहां पे ये सिस्टम मुझे सर्च ऑप्शन करने पर भी यहाँ पे लेके आ गया. सो नाउ दिस ऑर्डर इज आल्सो विजिबल टू मी एंड दिस अपील एप्लीकेशन एंड पार्ट पेमेंट टैब इज आल्सो अवेलेबल विद मी. सो दिस टैब इटसेल्फ डिनोट्स दैट यू हैव टू फाइल दिस अपील एप्लीकेशन एंड अलोंग विद दैट अपील एप्लीकेशन आल्सो यू कैन पे द अमाउंट पार्ट पेमेंट अमाउंट. आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन दैट अपील एप्लीकेशन एंड पार्ट पेमेंट अमाउंट. Now you can see the appeal application screen form 310, appeal against order of assessment wagara wagara. Now you can see that the two desk, this is appellate officer desk, is automatically populated over here. That is based on the table maintained in the system. Then this fields, whatever fields are there, all these fields are populated. As I had told you earlier that appeal module is linked with the registration module. It is linked with the assessment. Data pop-up hota hai aur plus assessment module se data pop-up hota hai. Date of order against which the appeal is filed. Date of receipt of order. date of assessing officer, designation of assessing officer, type of order, whether it is regular order or ex parte order, act under which order is passed, it is MVAT or CST Act, period of order means assessment year, and for which period the order is passed. ऐसे सब ये details जो है वो assessment module से auto fetch होके आते हैं. You don't require to fill all these details while filing the appeal application. Now for opening the table of appeal application, मैंने यहाँ पे click किया है. यहाँ पे मुझे appeal application का table यहाँ पे open हो गया है. You can see the details as per assessment, as per applicant field column is there. Third column is for disputed amount and fourth column is for undisputed amount. That third and fourth column is non-editable and it is auto-fetched, auto-calculated. First column is as per assessment. यहाँ पे जो जो figures है, all these figures are fetched from the assessment order form bundle which the officer had issued on assessment module. So what the dealer is required to do is that he had to उसके पास अगर ready working है तो वो यहाँ पे working upload कर रहे हैं. I don't want to content on the sale and GT of sales and purchase, so just मैं उसको copy paste करता हूँ. मुझे ये जो tax payable before adjusting credit, ये gross tax payable है. ITC available and other credit, it is as per the assessment order. And this balance tax payable is tax payable after adjustment of credit minus ITC available minus other credit. So यहाँ से यहाँ पे this balance tax payable is the just a minute, मेरा VPN down हो गया है, मुझे उसको reconnect करने दीजिए. So this is gross tax payable. Disputed amount does not determine from the gross tax payable. It is determined by the net tax payable after adjustment of this ITC and other credit. How it is done, I will show you that. If the dealer is accepting the gross tax payable 73186, मैंने वो figure यहाँ पे enter किया. So you can see that this column यहाँ पे zero आ गया. Undisputed amount is 73186. But the dealer is contending that instead of ITC granted to me in the assessment order 27,000, मुझे ITC चाहिए, say for example same amount का चाहिए 73,186. So balance tax payable as per my calculation becomes zero. वो यहाँ पे reflect हो गया है यहाँ पे, okay? So this 45,435 मैंने entire amount dispute में डाला है क्योंकि मुझे कुछ भी accepted नहीं है. अगर मुझे यहाँ पे 50,000 ITC चाहिए तो मैंने यहाँ पे 50,000 डाला, उसके अकॉर्डिंगली यहाँ पे 23,186 यहाँ पे रिफ्लेक्ट हो गया, और आउट ऑफ दैट 45,14 ये उसके अकॉर्डिंगली यहाँ के फर्दर के फिगर्स चेंज होते जाते हैं. सो मैं यहाँ पे एक एग्जांपल के लिए 73,186 डालता हूँ और नीचे भी आपको कैलकुलेशन दिखाता हूँ. सो यहाँ पे मेरा ऑटोमेटिकली बैलेंस टैक्स पेएबल बिकम जीरो. ये पहले से सेव करके रखा हुआ था, ये छोड़ देते हैं. अभी यहाँ पे मैं आता हूँ. अदर क्रेडिट में समझो 1,000 रुपए डाल दिया मैंने. टैक्स पेड बिफोर असेसमेंट से मैंने 10,000 रुपए असेसमेंट के पहले भरा हुआ था, उसका भी मैंने यहाँ पे डाल दिया. Whether desired to file the application for stay, type of stay, final stay or auto stay, दोनों available है. Final stay मैंने select किया. So this 4,543 amount of tax, it is auto generated. यहाँ पे 45,435, उसके accordingly ये 10% यहाँ पे generate हुआ है 4,543 amount. Major issue, ये appeal fees भी है auto generated रहता है. Based on the quantum of relief sought by the dealer, यहाँ पे major issue का एक drop down दिया है which is mandatory to be filed by updated by the dealer. मैं एक example के लिए यहाँ पे लेता हूँ, ITC related कुछ तो लेता हूँ यहाँ पे from return non filer purchases. Grounds of appeal यहाँ पे enter करने के लिए भी दिए हैं, but ड्यू टू सिस्टम कंस्ट्रेंट यहाँ पे मैक्सिमम 500 कैरेक्टर्स का ही ग्राउंड हाउस अपील अपडेट कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पे मैसेज भी आपको यू कैन सी दैट मैसेज यू कैन एंटर अप टू 500 कैरेक्टर्स इन दिस ब्लॉक. फॉर एनी एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन टू बी सबमिटेड यू कैन अटैच द डॉक्यूमेंट इन अटैचमेंट सेक्शन प्रोवाइडेड बिलो. सो ग्राउंड हाउस अपील मैंने जस्ट यहाँ पे कुछ तो टाइप कर रहा हूँ मैं, और मेरे पास एक मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अपील डिटेल में है, वो मैं यहाँ पे अपलोड कर रहा हूँ अभी. कोई भी सैंपल में ले लेता हूँ. एग्जाम्पल के लिए मैंने ये फाइल अटैच कर दिया. देन यू हैव टू क्लिक अपलोड फाइल. अपलोड इज सक्सेसफुल. ऐसे आप 5 MB तक फाइल यहाँ पे अटैच कर सकते हैं. मल्टीपल नंबर ऑफ फाइल्स कैन बी अटैच ओवर हियर. इफ यू वांट दैट सम ऑफ द फाइल इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू बी अटैच, तो यहाँ पे डिलीट का ऑप्शन दिया है. यू कैन एक्सरसाइज दिस ऑप्शन टू डिलीट दिस फाइल सो दैट इट विल नॉट गो अप विद द अपील एप्लीकेशन. आफ्टर वॉट एवर वर्किंग एंड वॉट एवर अटैचमेंट वॉट एवर डिटेल्स इज बीन फाइल्ड बाय द डीलर, यू कैन सी द बिलो देर आर टू टैब्स बिलो, सेव एंड प्रिंट प्रीव्यू एंड प्रोसीड टू पे एंड सबमिट. So as I said earlier, there is option of save is available to the dealer. यहाँ पे अगर मैं save and print preview करता हूँ तो ये application जैसे है वैसे save हो जाता है. ये table values भी सब वैसे ही save हो जाते हैं. So किसी ने मुझे थोड़ी देर some days before somebody has asked me कि मुझे
sir, your presentation is
हाँ दिनेश जी बोला.
Your presentation was not visible for some time. Okay, now it is visible.
वो VPN down झालेला, तुम्ही VPN परत reconnect केलेला
आहे. Okay,
now it is visible.
Yes.
Okay. So मगाशी दिनेश जी ने सांगितलेलं तसं सेव चा ऑप्शन नाहीये असं कोणीतरी म्हणत होतं, पण this save option was present right from day one when the appeal module went live. Okay, so this save option मी इकडे save क्लिक केल्यानंतर मला इकडे ऍप्लिकेशन माझं सेव्ह होतं आणि मला इकडे पीडीएफ देखील दिसते की पीडीएफ आहे, बट दिस इज ड्राफ्ट पीडीएफ ऍज इट इज नॉट येट दॅट पार्ट पेमेंट इज नॉट येट पेड. सो सेव्हचं ऑप्शन आहे. त्याच्यानंतर तुम्ही ही स्क्रीन लॉग आउट करू शकता. जेव्हा तुम्हाला परत लॉग इन करायचं आहे किंवा डीलरला तुम्ही सांगू शकता की तू आता लॉग इन कर, आणि नंतर तो लॉग इन झाल्यानंतर त्याने ओपन केल्यानंतर त्याला ही स्क्रीन जशी आहे तशी ह्या टेबल व्हॅल्यूज वगैरे सगळ्या तशा तशा दिसतील. ही जी फाईल अपलोड वगैरे केलेली आहे हे पण सर्व तसं तसं दिसेल त्याला. आणि आफ्टर दॅट इफ इट इज सॅटिस्फाईड विथ दॅट की बाबा हा हे सगळं बरोबर वगैरे भरलेले आहे, किंवा तुम्ही स्वतः सॅटिस्फाईड झालेले आहेत, मी स्वतः चार्टर्ड अकाउंट माझ्याकडे डीलरचा आहे, बँक अकाउंटचा ऍक्सेस आहे, व्हॉटएव्हर, तर मी ही इफ आय एम सॅटिस्फाईड की हे सगळं बरोबर भरल्यानंतर मी इकडे प्रोसीड टू पे अँड सबमिटचा ऑप्शन क्लिक करेल. But I request everybody to first get yourself 100% confirmed before clicking this proceed to pay and submit option. Because once you click on this proceed to pay and submit option, you move on from appeal module to the payment module. And once the payment module उसमें चले जाने के बाद यहाँ पे कुछ आप edit नहीं कर सकते. But as I am confirmed now कि हे सगळं मी बरोबर भरलेला आहे, तो मी proceed to pay and submit ला क्लिक करेल. यहाँ पे वापस एक मैसेज आपको इंश्योर करने के लिए दिया गया है, प्लीज इंश्योर दैट द डेटा इन एप्लीकेशन इज करेक्ट, वंस यू क्लिक ऑन प्रोसीड बटन नो चेंजेस कैन बी मेड इन एप्लीकेशन, आर यू श्योर यू वांट टू प्रोसीड. याच्याबरोबर जी अपील फाइल करण्यासाठी जे अमाउंट पेमेंट करायची आहे ती देखील इकडे रिफ्लेक्ट होताना तुम्हाला दिसेल. अमाउंट पेएबल फॉर फाइलिंग अपील इज 4643. मी ह्याला एज आय एम श्युअर की हे बरोबर आहे, मी ह्याला प्रोसीड ला क्लिक करतोय.
शिंदे साहेब
यस
पीपल आर रिक्वेस्टिंग People are requesting to speak in Hindi or English, no Marathi.
okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, मैंने proceed for payment को click करने के बाद this यहाँ पे payment module में अभी हम लोग आ गए. So, you all aware about this payment screen? ये GRASS का option है और SBI का option है. So, whatever option you can choose, you can opt that option and then further you can process that application. जब भी आपका पेमेंट सक्सेस अभी एज दिस इज आई एम वर्किंग इन क्वालिटी सर्वर सो आई कैन नॉट पे दैट अमाउंट फ्रॉम दिस क्वालिटी सर्वर, बट यू ऑल आर अवेयर हाउ टू पे दिस. इसके आगे जो पेमेंट कैसे करना है वो आपको पता है. आफ्टर सक्सेसफुल पेमेंट आपको स्क्रीन एक विजिबल हो जाता है जिसमें अपील एप्लीकेशन आईडी भी आपको मिल जाता है प्लस अपील एप्लीकेशन का एक्नोलेजमेंट भी मिल जाता है. सो दिस इज हाउ द अपील एप्लीकेशन इज फाइल्ड. दिस इज आई हैव टेकन दिस एग्जांपल ऑफ वन टेस्ट केस विच वॉज अवेलेबल विथ मी. अभी ये क्वालिटी सर्वर से बाहर निकल के मैं एक एक्चुअल डीलर सर्वर पे एक ऑर्डर दिखाता हूँ कि उसका एप्लीकेशन कैसे फाइल करते हैं. I am opening the website. Somebody is, I think, marking this screen. I don't know how it is being done. So I am logging into VAT and Allied X. मेरे पास एक टेस्ट तीन नंबर अवेलेबल है, वो मैं यहाँ पे एंटर कर रहा हूँ. I'm entering the password over here. ये actually dealer portal production में जो आप लोग को portal available है यहाँ पे मैं login कर रहा हूँ एक test case लेके. यहाँ पे यू कैन सी द टाइल ऑफ अपील ओवर हियर. आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस टाइल. ये टाइल पे क्लिक करने के बाद यहाँ पे अपील और अपील टू ट्रिब्यूनल से दो ऑप्शंस अवेलेबल हो जाते हैं. एज आई एम फाइलिंग द अपील टू द फर्स्ट अपीलेट अथॉरिटी आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस अपील टाइल. ये जो मैंने पहले थोड़ी देर पहले क्वालिटी सर्वर पे जो आपको बताया था वो स्क्रीन वापस ओपन हो गया है. मैं यहाँ पे ऑर्डर आई डी डाल रहा हूँ. Clicking on display. So, अभी मुझे appeal application part payment rectification payment तीनों tab open हो गए हैं. I'm clicking on this appeal application and part payment tab. You can see that there are three tabs available in that earlier screen. Appeal application and part payment. Second tab is for rectification and third tab is for payment. So you can file the rectification application against this order from this screen also. You can pay the regular assessment dues from this screen also. Now you can see that appeal application screen is open now. Jo maine earlier I had told you that you don't need to enter this. विनोद जी होस्ट डिस्प्लेड पार्टिसिपेंट डिसेबल्ड पार्टिसिपेंट स्क्रीन शेअरिंग चा ऑप्शन इकडे दिसतोय. ओके स्क्रीन दिसते का आता तुम्हाला?
हो दिसते दिसते.
एवरीवन इज एबल टू व्ह्यू द स्क्रीन नाउ?
येस
दिसते.
ओके ओके. सो ये सब ऑटो पॉपुलेट होके आ गया. यहाँ पे मैंने ऑर्डर फॉर्म पे क्लिक कर रहा हूँ. मैं मुझे मेरा जो वर्किंग है वो यहाँ पे भरना है. एज दिस ऑर्डर इज यू कैन सी दिस ऑर्डर इज रिजल्टेड इनटू रिफंड अमाउंट. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर ऑर्डर नो पार्ट पेमेंट विल बी आस्क्ड बाय द डीलर. ऑफिसर ने 30,25,000 चा रिफंड दिलेला, बट आय वॉन्ट द रिफंड ऑफ 58,76,000 समथिंग. हे बाकीचे मी आता भरत नाहीये कारण इट विल कंझ्युम मोर टाइम. टॅक्स पेड बिफोर असेसमेंट से इट इज झिरो. तुम्ही आता इकडे बघाल की पार्ट पेमेंट अमाऊंट इकडे झिरो रुपीज डिटरमाइंड झाले बिकॉज द असेसमेंट ऑर्डर हॅज रिझल्टेड इन टू रिफंड. जर नील ड्यूज किंवा रिफंडचे जर केस असेल तर ह्याच्या ह्या दोन्ही केसमध्ये सिस्टीम तुम्हाला पार्ट पेमेंट मागत नाही. सो ओनली बाय पेईंग द अपील फीज यू कॅन फाईल द अपील ऍप्लिकेशन. आता तुम्हाला इकडे कंटोनेशन ऍप्लिकेशनचा एक ऑप्शन दिसत असेल, तो कसा आला ते पण मी सांगतो तुम्हाला. एक इकडे मी ग्राउंड्स ऑफ अपील माझ्याकडे कॉपी पेस्ट पण मी करू शकतो किंवा टाईप पण करू शकतो. मी दोन फाईल इकडे ऑलरेडी सबमिट करून ठेवल्या होत्या काल टेस्टिंगसाठी, त्या दोन फाईल इकडे दिसत आहेत. काल मी हे सेव्ह फक्त दोन फाईल इकडे अटॅच करून ठेवलेल्या सेव्ह करून. नाऊ हाऊ दिस डिले कंडोनेशन ऍप्लिकेशन इज, वाय दिस डिले कंडोनेशन ऍप्लिकेशन इज व्हिजिबल, बिकॉज यू कॅन सी दॅट द असेसमेंट ऑर्डर इट इज सर्व्हिस्ड ऑन 2nd December 2019. Date of receipt of order is 2nd December 2019, 2/12/2019. So system captures that date, and as it is more than 60 days now, so system automatically displays the delay condonation application to be filed by the dealer. मी याच्यावरती क्लिक केलं. डिले कंडोनेशन ऍप्लिकेशन मध्ये काहीही भरायचं नाहीये. ओनली एक तुम्हाला कंडोनेशन रिझन दिलेले आहेत ड्रॉपडाऊन मध्ये. मी एक रिझन सिलेक्ट केलं, हेल्थ रिझन ऑफ फॅमिली मेंबर्स. मी इकडे माझं काहीतरी हे केलं, टाईप केलं. तुम्हाला डिले कंडोनेशन साठी समजा काही फाईल अटॅच करायची असेल, म्हणजे डिटेल डिले कंडोनेशनचं तुम्हाला काही मेन्शन करायचं असेल, तर तुम्ही इकडे मी ज्या फाईल मगाशी अटॅचमेंटमध्ये फाईल केलेल्या आहेत तशा तुम्ही तुमचे डिले कंडोनेशनचं देखील सबमिशन इकडे अटॅच करू शकता. सो दिस ऍप्लिकेशन ऍप्लिकेशनमध्ये तुम्हाला वर्ड फाईल देखील अटॅच करता येते. एखादं एक्सेल असेल ती पण अटॅच करता येते. पीडीएफ असेल ती पण अटॅच करता येते. सो तसं डिले कंडोनेशनचं काही समजा तुम्हाला डिटेल सबमिशन करायचं असेल तर तुम्हाला इकडे मेन अपील ऍप्लिकेशनची स्क्रीन आहे, इकडे तुम्हाला हे अटॅचमेंटमध्ये ही डिले कंडोनेशनचं रिझन देखील डिटेलमध्ये अटॅच करता येतं. हे झाल्यानंतर मी परत मगाशी जसं सांगितलं तसं सेव्ह अँड प्रिंट प्रिव्ह्यूचं ऑप्शन आहे आणि प्रोसीड टू पे अँड सबमिटचं ऑप्शन आहे. मी समजा प्रोसीड टू पे अँड सबमिटचं ऑप्शन क्लिक केलं तर मला मगाशी जो मेसेज दिसला तो हा दिसतोय. इकडे फक्त अपील फीज इकडे डिस्प्ले होते कारण ही रिफंडची अमाऊंट हे आहे. इकडे प्रोसीड केल्यानंतर मगाशी जशी पेमेंटची स्क्रीन व्हिजिबल झालेली तशी एक स्क्रीन व्हिजिबल झाली आहे. मी लोकेशन सिलेक्ट करतो. मी आता ऍक्च्युअली इकडे पेमेंट करून बघतोय एक सॅम्पल म्हणून. ड्राफ्ट चलन जे क्रिएट होत आहे त्याच्यामध्ये फक्त तुम्ही बघाल की फीस ड्राफ्ट.
सर रिक्वेस्ट टू स्पीक इन हिंदी ऑर इंग्लिश.
ओके सॉरी मी मध्येच हे होतोय. सो आय कॅन सी द ड्राफ्ट चलन ओव्हर हिअर. इट इज ऑटोमॅटिकली जनरेटेड. यू कॅन सी द अपील फीज ऑफ 1,000 rupees ओव्हर हिअर अँड द टोटल अमाऊंट इज पेएबल ऑल्सो इज फ्रॉम फॉर 1,000 rupees. एज दिस ऑर्डर इज हॅज रिझल्टेड इन टू रिफंड अमाऊंट सो देर इज नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ पार्ट पेमेंट फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर ऑर्डर. I have only required to pay the appeal fees. Accordingly, the draft challan also shows the appeal fees over here, 1,000 rupees. Now I am clicking on make payment option type available over here. I am entering the internet banking. If you are going to pay from SBI or other banks, you can select the requisite option over here. I have to enter the details of my bank account. for entering this OTP. All these things are being done in payment module. Now you are out of this appeal module and you are in, working in payment module. I don't know how, why it is. Let us try again. I think there is some error being displayed over here. I cannot pay the amount from my debit card, so I will not further proceed this appeal application. But after paying this amount, you can see the window of payment successfully done, and in that window you get the appeal application acknowledgement, also the appeal application number and the chalan for which you have paid the amount. Dinesh ji, ye do application to maine dikha diye. You want some more application to be test check for over here?
If it is same, then it is not required to show again, no?
This flow is very much similar to each other, but I just want to show one more application.
Not required.
I just want to show one more application. How the miscellaneous appeal is filed, because few days before you had submitted that the registration application cannot be filed this. So I will show one more application.
Yes, this, please.
How to file the miscellaneous appeals. I'm going through the same gateway. Clicking on this appeals tab. As the miscellaneous application, I don't know the number of what is the number of order for this registration cancellation order. I'm just selecting the one of the act, Central Sales Tax Act. I'm selecting some kind of order. Entering the period over here. So I have to submit the search criteria. Now you can see that there is miscellaneous appeals tab displayed over here. The message is also given, please verify the period along with the dues. As I told you earlier, there is one more gateway where the dealer can file the appeal application against the non-SAP orders also. If the SAP order is available, if for the purpose of non-SAP order, the line item as displayed earlier over here, that is also displayed here. You can click on that line item to open the appeal application for non-SAP order. only difference in SAP and non-SAP appeal application is that in SAP application, all the details in as per assessment columns are auto-fetched by the system. You don't need to enter the assessment figures. For non-SAP orders, that as per assessment order column is left blank and it is left editable. The data is required to be entered
sir,
by the
sir, date correct केली तर मला वाटतं पुढे देईल ना
नाही त्याचं ह्याच्याशी काय कनेक्शन नाहीये इट इज जस्ट आय जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू शो हाउ दिस मिसलेनियस अपील ऍप्लिकेशन टॅब इज ओपन ओवर हियर ओके
डेट यू हॅव एंटर्ड इन पीरियड
नाही हां ठीक
आहे दॅट हॅज नो कनेक्शन
ओके ती डेट ओके ठीक आहे टायपो एरर होता तरी पण तो मी येणार नाही कारण मी इसमें कुछ भी डेटा नहीं था इसके लिए मैंने क्लिक करा था Now this, I can see the miscellaneous appeal tab over here. I can click this tab to file the miscellaneous appeals. Now you can see that there is no data in two desk over here because system does not know which officer has passed this registration cancellation order. Now I will enter this data over here. It is registration cancellation order. Date of order say it is... in the month of December.
Sir, can you please show what are the options which are there in the drop-down menu?
It is assessment order, registration cancellation order and other order. This assessment okay. order is particularly for those orders which are passed on non-SAP system and resulted into refund.
Okay. Okay.
Everything, okay. every detail okay. has been given in the appeal okay. manual which is available on website. Okay.
okay. Okay.
Now I am selecting this registration cancellation order tab. Date of order is 2/12/2019, but I have received this order in say 12 May 2020. Okay. Now I have to enter the desk ID of the dealer, desk ID of the assessing officer who has passed this order. Just entering that now. For example, it is 601. I have to click the validate tab. Now this. As I entered this application tab properly, yahan pe, you can see the application desk to whom the appeal application is going to be allocated. I have to select the type of order, whether it is regular registration cancellation orders or say ex parte order without knowing, without considering the facts of the case. So if that is so, I have selected that ex parte order option tab, act under which order is passed. I am selecting the CST Act. Okay. There is no requirement to enter the period over here because registration cancellation order is not passed for particular period. That date is auto-fetched from the as per the date of order for which the registration cancellation order is passed. I'm just selecting these remaining details. For this particular order, there is no requirement of part payment. Only thing is that this appeal fees is required to be paid along with this order. For major issues, I have to select some issues and that baki remaining jo procedure hai, that is totally same as per earlier appeal applications which we had seen few time before. Grounds of appeal, you can enter over here, you can upload the file, you can save and print preview the file, you can proceed to pay and submit. Form 311 is also available over here. So all in all, the basic structure of the appeal application remains the same. Only thing is that the applicant is required to identify the nature of order against which he is required to file the appeal, whether that order is passed on SAP system or whether that order is passed on non-SAP system. Accordingly, all these gateways are available. The details of this explanatory details and screenshots and other things are available on the website in the appeal manual, which is published on 30th November 2019 along with the trade circular. If there are any issues as far as this this appeal manual, if you want it to be more explanatory or something like that, you can go through that appeal manual and subsequently you can anytime communicate me. There are certain corrections are required to be made in that appeal manual because that manual is initially prepared by our system integrator. But if there are any corrections required to be done in that manual, we are always open for that corrections. Now, as far as this second part of how to file this appeal application is concerned, I am finished with the second part. We have gone through the SAP order, we have gone through the registration order, we have gone through this one payable order, one refundable order. Now, as far as Dineshji, can we start the third part, or we want to see some more things on this?
No, we can start with the third part because third part is relating to queries, right?
Right.
Yeah, so we can start with the queries because we are already 1 o'clock.
Okay.
So reaching to 1 o'clock. So we can start with the queries.
See, as far as these queries are concerned, I had received a mail yesterday from Mr. Sunil Joshi that these are the few queries which are means there might be many queries, but he has segregated those queries into compiled those queries into various categories, and accordingly he had sent me those queries on the mail. Today morning when I got some time, I went through those queries, and we can see you can see those queries on the on your screen, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So we will go through these queries one by one. We'll go the first queries with respect to order passed on Mahavikas but not displayed on portal. As I had told you earlier, it is with respect to the recovery module where the officer was required to transfer that assessment order dues which are raised in Mahavikas system from recovery utility to recovery module. That process is being done through bulk uploading now. Earlier, it was expected that the officer are required to transfer this assessment case dues case by case, but as it is taking a bit long time, and due to the lockdown issues and other things, department has decided that we'll bulk upload those assessment order dues from old Mahavikas system into recovery module, new SAP recovery module. So that is being done now through bulk uploading facility that is under development, and hopefully next say 10 to 15 days all those previous assessment order dues which are or the orders which are passed on Mahavikas will be transferred on SAP system. Dealer can see those recovery dues through on this appeal application also, and accordingly they can identify the recovery line item and they can file the appeal application through this appeal module. So I just recovery module is being updated regularly, bulk uploading is progress. That is the answer, basic answer for this issue. Error in downloading assessment order. So if the nodal officer has not updated the date of service of order to the dealer, then the error has generated, that is as follows: please contact the nodal officer to update the order service status on SAP system and try again. Basically, dealer is not required to do that. Honestly speaking, dealer is not required to do that. The assessing officer is required to carry out the perform the functions of passing of assessment order as well as service of the assessment order on SAP system. So if he had already serviced that order through SAP system, the dealer cannot face this issue, first thing. Second thing, if he has not performed that function, we had weekly deriving the report of the cases which are not serviced through SAP system. We are sharing those data with the concerned nodal officers for performing those function of service of order on SAP system. And that is being done regularly now. So, but if at all such any issues is remotely identified by the dealer ki aisa nahi dikh raha hai, so you can contact that nodal officer through telephone also, and you can ask nodal officer to service the order. But we are because I had also escalated this issue in various meeting with the commissioner office, so that thing is being done regularly by the assessing officers now, the number of cases for which this issue will faced by the dealer will drastically come down. I am sure about that. Third issue is with respect to credit of tax payment made prior to online appeal application. I would like to draw your attention to the trade circular which is issued on 30th November 2019. The para 10 of that trade circular particularly deals for those cases for which the dealer has paid certain part payment amount before go live of this appeal application. Para 10 of that circular caters to two categories of cases. One is for part payment made prior to filing of appeal application on SAP system, and second is for the cases where the recovery has been kept in abeyance under section 23(8). So for these two particular cases, the dealer can file the manual appeal application. After submission of this manual appeal application, the appellate officer is expected to upload that case from back end into the appeal module, so that this issue is already being taken care through the trade circular issued on 30th November. Okay, fourth issue is with respect to wrong calculation of part payment at the rate 10%. Somebody has asked that 10% is calculated on gross liability, that is before giving credit of ITC and other credit. So whatever I showed you while the demo of this appeal application, it is with respect to the balance tax payable. So credit of whatever ITC and other credit is given in the assessment order, uska sabka credit hone ke baad hi part payment determine hota hai. The detailed scenario of various kind of part payment that is also incorporated in the appeal manual, which is extensively dealt with the various scenarios of this part payment under VAT and CST Act. You can go through that. Okay, so this issue is not applicable in this particular application. Issue in appeal should not be specific. In Form 310, the appellant has to select the issue. Somebody has raised the issue that they have to select from the drop down issues available in the appeal screen, which is required to be mandatorily required to be filled up. Basic purpose of this incorporating the drop down is to highlight the particular category of cases for which the appeal is being filed. Say for example, if the appeal is being filed for many cases are being filed for ITC mismatch or CST differential dues. So department can categorize those cases for early disposal of appeal. Department can identify the cases, common issues against which the appeal is filed. So for that identification purpose also, that drop down is essential, and it is good to have feature in the module. As far as detail issues which the dealer is required to communicate to the appellate officer, as I have shown you earlier, you can upload your detailed submission in the appeal memorandum, either in Word file or say PDF. You can convert that Word into PDF. You can upload that into the appeal screen attachment. So that caters the requirement actually. So it is not the big issue. Yes.
In that scenario, no. If any other issue what are listed, the dealer cannot choose that. Can you have the other option for that?
So we'll incorporate any other option in that drop down list.
Yeah.
So that is not yet available. Okay. Any other option, as per your observation.
Yes, please. Thank you.
We'll incorporate that any other option. Kadambe. I request my co-module leaders to note down this this requirement, that any other option is required to be incorporated in the drop down list of major issues involved, and also in the drop down list of delay condonation reasons. Okay, so this sixth point is the more or less similar to the fifth point. Reason for delay in appeal filing to be mentioned in delay condonation application should not be specific. It is the same issue, so we'll incorporate the drop down of any other in that drop down menu options. The seventh point is with respect to online stay of recovery may be granted to the appellant after selecting auto stay and making part payment. Okay, so online stay, as far as online stay is concerned, if you go through this section 26, the stay is to be granted by the appellate officer. But what we have done is that when the dealer selects auto stay and pays the requisite amount as per the auto stay option, system automatically stays the disputed amount from back end, and that recovery module also, in recovery module also, that not available amount is shown accordingly as per the option choose by the dealer. though the dealer cannot be dealer cannot receive the online stay, but system automatically stays that recovery. It is same modus operandi. It is same modus operandi employed in GST appeals also. When you file the GST appeal in APL 01, you have to pay the 10% of disputed amount and 100% of non-disputed amount. So there is no option of stay order available in GST, because the system automatically stays the remaining amount whatever disputed by the dealer. So same modus operandi is employed in this particular auto stay option also. System automatically stays that amount. So that care is already being taken by the system itself. Eighth option is, it is injustice if the appeal petition has auto rejected. There is footnote. Okay. See, what happens is that you are filing this appeal application on the system, and dealer is expected to fill in the correct and complete details, because once the appeal application is filed, there is very less chance of it is being edited. You can add, no doubt you can add the many other options while actually the appeal proceeding initiates. But as far as application is concerned, online application is concerned, once it is filed, it cannot be edited. So we had, keeping that thing in mind, we had particularly given this message. Otherwise also, as per the provision of the Act and rule, as per the provision of rule for this summary rejection, so the appellate officer is expected to, and it is bound to give the dealer the natural opportunity of being heard before passing any summary rejection order or say appeal dismissal order. So that in that appeal module from officer and the officer is, officer can issue the show cause notice online also before rejection of appeal. So that care is already taken in appeal officer portal. Now ninth option is, the form of adjournment application may be added to the portal. So there is no particular format of adjournment application provided in that. So we had not provided in the system also. But otherwise also, when the officer carries out the hearing in the appeal module, he has option to select the hearing status as adjourned on the request of the dealer, or adjourned as per the requirement of the officer. So that that option is available in the officer portal also. Tenth item is timeout period. It is notified that timeout period provided on the online system is too short and it may be increased. I think 2 minutes timeout period is provided in the system, but we'll talk to the NIT team whether that can be increased or not, because their major concern is with respect to the load on the system. Once if any dealers opens the appeal application or any other application for say, then the system automatically, there is burden on the system. If many dealers opens many application at the same time and keep the system, that keeps the system burdened without any reason. So accordingly, that timeout period is decided by the system integrator, but we'll talk to them on this. So I have written agreed on this issue. We'll see to it that whether this timeout period can be increased or not. Order passed on ACP system is not appearing on MGST portal. I think this is the same issue we had discussed earlier. The first issue was with respect to the same thing. Filing of appeal without part payment. If one of the contractor case we have applied for refund, the case was selected for assessment, but due to lockdown from March 20, the officer had passed base judgment order. The order heavy resulted into demand. See, this is the policy thing. Order, if the order has resulted into demand, you have to pay the part payment. So I cannot comment on this legal issue. Okay. The provisions are very clear about that. If you are not satisfied with the order, you can file the rectification application if the mistake is apparent on record, or you can file the appeal. These are the only two options.
There a courier case, the High Court has allowed to file an appeal without part payment.
You can definitely go into High Court, na? You can file the writ petition. Already some of the writ petitions are pending in the High Court for this provision, this amendment. So you can definitely file that. But as of now, the provision of the Act has remained the same. We don't. I cannot comment on what is the progress on that issue. Okay. You can represent the case to the commissioner office also, or if you wish, you can file the writ petition in the High Court also. Against those.
Yes, sir. We can go forward.
Definitely, you can go. Already, many. I think some of the writ petitions are pending in High Court on this amendment. Okay.
You can go to next question.
Okay. There is one just casual discussion. I'm just giving you the example. There is one case that the dealer came to me that with a complaint that assessing officer has not given the credit of whatever tax paid by the dealer by ad hoc payment, okay, without returns. So that is very wrong from the part of the assessing officer, because it is very much crystal clear that if the dealer has paid certain amount along with the return or say for ad hoc payment, so you have to give the credit of that payment, but he has not given that, and due to that the dealer is in receipt of this demand order. There is certain demand raised through this assessment order. So he was not inclined to file the appeal, because 10% part payment of that demand he was filing it to be wrongly done. So I had just advised him to file the rectification application, because that is mistake very much apparent on the record that if the dealer has not paid the dealer has paid certain amount that the officer has not given the credit of that amount. That is mistake very much apparent on record, and accordingly rectification application can suffice the purpose of that dealer. There is no need to file the appeal in certain kind of these particular cases, and accordingly then he files that appeal. So I would like all to first to explore the option of rectification, because in under section 24 there are certain more categories of rectification issues which are covered now, like ITC mismatch or CST differential dues. And if that rectification is it can suffice your purpose, there is no requirement to file the appeal, and then there is no requirement to pay that 10% part payment amount. Next, I will move on to next issue. No response to service request and emails. Actually, this is not directly connected to me, but I will talk to Mahavikas team. One officer from Mahavikas is already present in the meeting. So I would like that officer to take into consideration this issue. Also, I will communicate Mahavikas team that the this mail and service request are to be addressed within time. Okay. Delay due to technical glitches and filing of appeal through email. Sometimes despite of uploading of order, see what happens is that some of the dealers came up with a complaint that I have been mujhe to assessment order mere haath mein mil gaya, but the I cannot see the appeal application wagara. So when we go through the actually system through backend, what is the exact issue, then we came up with the finding that the assessing officer has actually serviced that order manually without servicing it on SAP system. So there is so as I told you earlier, we are extracting the reports of these cases where the order is not serviced on system, and the officers are being told that regular service of order of the assessment orders which are issued on SAP system are required to be done immediately. So so that thing is being communicated to the officers also. 15th issue is that credit of direct payment of part payment towards appeal. The party has paid part payment through SBI, not through appeal module. Now the appeal module is asking to pay. Okay, let me tell you one thing over here. The appeal module, you all know the section provision of section 40 that if you pay a certain amount against the dues, that amount first adjusted towards the interest, then it is adjusted towards the penalty, then it is adjusted toward any amount if it is forfeited, then finally fees, and if any amount remains, that is adjusted against the tax. So if the dealer pays certain amount in payment module without going through appeal module, So system automatically adjusts that amount with interest or say penalty, or if any amount remains, that amount is adjusted against tax. So there is no amount that challan is already gets adjusted against those requisite amounts. So there is no amount paid as such with against the disputed due. So I am again requesting you all to, if you want to file the appeal, please go through the appeal application screen. Please go through the appeal application payment so that this issue will not arise. Okay. As far as the payment made done earlier, before issuance of the trade circular or before issuance of before go live of this appeal module, we had catered this issue. As I told you earlier, it is explained in para 10 of that trade circular. If any amount is paid earlier, then the manual appeal can be filed against this issue. 16th issue is calculation of disputed amount for part payment. This is case specific issue. Whoever has raised this issue, please directly please contact to me. Let me go through that case and then we can discuss that issue. 17th number is change in date of receipt of order, delay in filing of appeal. While filing appeal, it is found that receipt of order is auto-populated as date of assessment order passed on SAP system. However, many a times it is found that dealer has not received the order on mail. See, we had particularly communicated various time to the dealer fraternity and to STPs and CAs also that you have to update your registered mail ID. You have to update your dealer profile, which is available with the department. Many a times what happens is that registered mail ID gets dormant due to some accountant gets transferred or retires and the new accountant came up, rejoins, and then he uses the new registered mail ID. So whatever mail ID available with the department, whatever registered mail ID available with the department registration module and in the dealer profile, the system automatically triggers a mail to that registered mail ID. Moreover, if you don't want to go through the registered mail ID, then all the orders are available on dealer portal. As I shown you earlier while giving the demo, if you are in receipt of the order, you can search that order in dealer portal also. So whenever the officer uploads any order on the system, that order is sent through system mail to the registered mail ID of the dealer, and it is also available on the dealer portal at the same time. The 18th issue is with respect to filing of tribunal appeals online and online hearing. As far as it is out of my scope because I am looking after the appeal module which is catered to deal with the first appeal only. As far as tribunal appeal and further legal process is concerned, there is one tribunal and legal module that is being developed by some other team. So it is in progress. I can only tell you about that. It is in progress. These are all the issues which I had received yesterday.
There are some other issues issued after the mail. I'll just share that issue, sir.
Huh? Just a minute, Sunil ji. स्टॉप शेयर कर रहा हूं मैं अभी ओके जस्ट अ मिनट हां ओके हां बताइए अभी
माय स्क्रीन सर
हां
सर द पेमेंट्स मेड टू चलन जनरेट जस्ट अ
मिनट यस कैरी ऑन
हां ओके
पेमेंट्स मेड टू चलन जनरेटेड by appeal module not fetched by the appeal module itself. The payments are made, but that is not captured by the appeal module.
Okay. See, I agree that there are certain issues with respect to payment module. As I told you earlier, once you click the tab on proceed to pay and submit, the applicant moves to the payment module. There are certain instances which we had identified where the payment is not immediately gone into successful category. होता क्या है कि payment जब या bank से आपका amount debit होता है वो RBI में चला जाता है. RBI से हमारा जो department का जो bank account है वहाँ से आता है. वो स्क्रोल कभी कभी अपडेट होने में टाइम लग जाता है. इन दोज पर्टिकुलर केसेस ओनली सच काइंड ऑफ इशू कैन बी आइडेंटिफाइड. बट द पेमेंट मॉड्यूल टीम हैज बीन कम्युनिकेटेड अबाउट दिस इशू. दे आर इन दे आर वर्किंग ऑन दैट थिंग.
Sir, when it delay is trying to file the appeal, since order result in the dues, please contact
this,
order
this office. Issue is already dealt by me in earlier. Sir,
can we file the luxury tax appeals on this module?
These as of now, the appeals are only available on VAT and CST Act.
Okay.
As far as other act appeals are concerned, the appellate officer are being are already instructed that other appeals are to be taken manually only.
Yeah.
Because there are very, very, very few number of cases of other appeals, and the efforts involved in developing all these other appeals online was much higher, frankly speaking.
Okay, sir. I just want to mention that the majority of the queries are drafted by our Ratnagiri member, Mr. Abhijit Berde.
Mm-hmm.
I will just mention that he has taken the effort for that. My colleague Vinod Maskey will take the further queries what are received today on the chat box.
Yes, sure.
Vinod, please take.
Thank you, Sunil. I just want to share my screen also. Yes. Near about 24 queries I have opted, and I will take selected one.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Sir, we have paid appeal part payment 10% of disputed amount before starting online filing appeal, but what after that, at the time of filing online appeal, there is no
Vinod
system.
Vinodji.
Yes.
I have already
dealt with that
communicated
one?
To you.
Okay.
Para 10 of the trade okay. circular particularly deals with such kind of cases, and the dealers are required to file the manual appeal in such kind of cases. Officers have been instructed to take this case manual.
Okay. Shall I go to the
see
next?
This third query is there.
Yeah, yeah.
That appeal filing limitation period is falling due to during lockdown period, whether it is extended due to lockdown till so government has extended the lockdown till 30th June. I don't know. see, as far as this lockdown issue is concerned, department has already issued circular number 72.
Sir, in this respect, let me tell you something. Though the lockdown period has not been extended till 30th June, we all know that it has been extended till 31st of May. And we are not allowed
yes.
to move out yes. of our home except for the essential things. Even if after 31st of May the lockdown is lifted, thereafter if the limitation period
department has already made
elaborate representation on this aspect. Just for the information of all the participants here, uh-huh. I'm saying this, that we have made the representation stating that if the limitation period has come to an end till 31st of May and dealer or the appellant has not been able to mobilize the things for filing appeal,
okay.
he has to consult with consultant, advocate, etc. And he will not be able to file appeals even after 31st of May for some time, because he has to mobilize those things and he has to prepare the appeal memo and all those things are there. So that some relief may be given by the government or the departmental officials or the functionaries. That request has already been made. And we know that you cannot do anything for this.
No.
Or commit
no, listen,
anything in this session. Yeah.
Dineshji, listen to me on this. Department has already issued circular number 70/2020 for this. Okay, where it is particularly communicated that during due to this lockdown and other unforeseen events, if the dealer is filing the there is some delay in filing the appeal, the appellate officer are instructed that you should not you should accept those appeals and you should not reject the appeal merely on the grounds of delay condonation reason is wrong or any other thing. Also, they have been instructed not to levy any compounding fees for this accepting these appeals. Okay.
Sir, our representation. Our representation is some people are saying that circular is not on site. Further request to that is this, that during this lockdown period, since the period of limitation for assessment has not been extended, there might be cases that expertise or the best judgment assessment orders would have been passed. In those cases, our specific request is that where the appellant dealer is requesting to remand the cases back for fresh opportunity of hearing for fresh assessments, in those cases, no part payment should be insisted, no appeal filing fees should be insisted, and opportunity of hearing may be given by way of fresh assessment. That is what is the request. So we know that this cannot be resolved in this mega guidance sale. Yes, sir.
Okay. Somebody has entered in the chat that the circular is not available on system. Let me go through that on website again. And if it is not available, I will ask the Mahavikas officials to upload that circular.
Sir, you can resolve that later on. Let us deal with the other queries. Going into the policy issues and the issues, let us deal with the technical issues. Which are directly relating to the filing of appeals.
हाँ विनोद जी गैप पड़े आता तुम्ही तुमसे है करा यू कैन कैरी ऑन ओके
सिक्स प्लीज गाइड अस हाउ टू फाइल अपील फॉर द असेसमेंट ऑर्डर पास बिफोर सैप सिस्टम एंड ड्यूज डू नॉट रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन पोर्टल हेंस नॉट एबल टू
ऑलरेडी आंसर्ड दिस इशू
ओके सर ओके ठीक
लग्जरी टैक्स
आई विल गो टू द सम टेक्निकल इश्यूज त्याच्यामध्ये आहे Sir, I have applied for appeal, but was not able to issue the acknowledgement number. Now, how can I get the acknowledgements?
I had applied for appeal, but what able
to serial number 9.
So I need to go through the this issue particularly. Okay. मतलब उसने apply किया मतलब क्या किया payment चलन whether that चलन is generated that successful payment चलन whether that message is received. Then also the appeal acknowledgement is not generated. I need to actually go through the facts of that case. No?
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you. We'll convey them.
If any, let me tell you everyone. If any particular STP or dealer or say chartered accountant are facing this particular issue, you can raise the service request or you can directly as and when I am available on phone. Many people call to me directly and I try to resolve their issues on real time basis. But if at all it is not resolved, just give me it is not resolved for this from through the service request portal. You can directly call to me. Okay.
Sir, 12 number. Please guide about the status of part payment done for first appeal at the time of second appeal, that is the first part payment is made
out of my scope.
These are the general queries which one will have to go through the law. Is the part payment under the law under section 26 for second
appeal?
I see the queries all the queries are not relevant or the relating directly to the subject. Most of them are legal and policy related.
Okay.
May I ask? I have some queries which I have noted, which are I think relevant. Can I ask those queries?
Yes.
Shinde sir, date of receipt of order is auto fetch. Can you please highlight on which date is considered for the date of receipt?
I will show you the. I will try to connect to the assessment module. Okay, if it is connected, then I can show you the which date is fetched. Just. Mm-hmm. sharing the screen now. Now this is officer portal. I have logged in. I'm going to audit and assessment module. We'll just try to find some cases for assessment order first.
Sir, meanwhile, shall I ask one thing?
Yeah, sure.
Attachment of that 5 MB, it's per file or it's a total 5 MB attachment can be done?
Total 5 MB.
Total 5 MB, no? Okay, sir.
Yeah.
And is there any chance that we can sir, delay them from the
sir, bank? Sir, on that 5 MB, I'm on 5 MB only. Now, Dushi,
yeah.
Wait for some time. Sir, that 5 MB will not be sufficient in some cases where the dealer will want to attach some evidences or some declarations or maybe.
How many pages do you expect the receipt per appeal application? How many pages?
We will work on that and we will make separate representation because in that respect.
Because we had tested almost 300 to 400 pages
okay.
were uploaded when we test check okay. the cases.
Okay. Okay.
We'll try to explore that also. मतलब उसमें क्या कोई हर्ज नहीं है चेक करने में. But that okay, unnecessary gives the load on system and unnecessary सब वो application ये हो जाता है. But we'll try to explore okay. that also. No issues.
Okay. Okay. Achha, meanwhile, when you're doing this,
you can ask the queries, yes.
Sure. Yeah, meanwhile, we will discuss the issues. See, we are practically, though you, during the representation, you have stated that the data is getting saved on the website, even there's option to save. And if the advocate wants to convey his client to make payment, he can ask him to log in and make payment and thereafter submit the appeal from his end with the saved data. That is what you conveyed during his presentation. But still people are saying that actually whatever we are uploading or saving on the portal is not getting saved once we log out from it without making payment.
If any particular case, if you can show me any particular case, na, then yes. I can forward this issue to yes. the technical person also. But as far as what we had tested, whatever is saved by the dealer or say any person, that remains over there.
Yes, sir.
Now I will open this assessment order screen.
Yeah.
See, this is the assessment order screen, which is used by the officer for passing the assessment order. Okay. You can see the bottom right corner of the screen. There are three dates mentioned over here. Order issued date, order e-service date, and order service. This is actually order service confirmed date. Okay. This is the date of order on which the dealer officer has passed the assessment order. Okay. This is 7th March 2019 is the date on which the officer has sent, that system has sent the order to the dealer on his registered mail ID and dealer portal. Then also the officer has given functionality to update the actual service confirmation date, where the officer has shown it as 26 March 2019. Okay. So this order service confirm date, which is last date of the system, is picked up by the appeal module for the purpose of deciding on which date the order is serviced to the dealer.
Okay. So that, sir, here only thing which I would like to mention is that the dealer or the appellant is left at the mercy of the assessing officer to put the date of service of the order. Why the dealer or the appellant should not be given the freedom to put his date of actual receipt of the order, and then thereafter it is the part of the proceeding, appeal proceeding, to decide whether the appeal is delayed or is in time.
See, this is not only with respect to appeal module. Whatever date is entered by the assessing officer is entered after he must be having the evidences in the file that the order is served on 27th March. Okay. So only after that he can enter that date. It is not only linked with the appeal module, it is linked with the payment module also, and it is linked with the recovery module also. So, as and when that date is entered, that 30 days time period for the purpose of recovery or 60 days time period for the purpose of appeal and other things are counted from that particular date only. It is cautious decision taken by the department that particular date is required to be taken into consideration for this, all these modules. Okay.
Sir, we appreciate. Only that date should not be linked with the filing date for the appeal, for the sake that there may be cases that dealer would substantiate with evidence that this particular order was not received on the date which is mentioned by the assessing officer. That may happen. There may be cases. So it would be our request that the date should be filled by the appellant rather than keeping that auto filled.
Where the assessment order is not passed on SAP system, all these particular dates are required to be entered by the dealer only, because system does not have that data. But where the system is in possession of that particular data which is available on system, without using it, it will be impractical.
Okay, fine, sir. We may differ in our opinion. We will make formal representation in this respect.
Bilkul.
Yeah. Sure. May I move forward to my subsequent query?
Sure.
That is relating to 311, which is the stay application. We could not see there is an option to file 311. We had received that query in the chat box. Yeah.
311 is now not required to be filed where the assessment orders are passed post 15/4/2017. It is mentioned in this trade circular issued for this purpose in 2017 only.
So, do you mean to say that there will be auto stay once the appeal is filed?
It is not auto stay. That final, the appellate officer is required to file, required to pass the final stay order as per the merit of the case. You need not upload the form 311 now. And even post 2017. Up to the goal of appeal module, form 311 was not required for manual filing of appeal also.
Yeah, these points we will be noting for representation. Our L&R convener, Mr. Aditya Surte, is there.
And also we will take these points in the proposed FAQs also. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, because there's issue of recovery, because once I file appeal and
only when the assessment order is passed for interest or penalty purpose, then only form 311 automatically appears over there. Otherwise, it is not required to be filed. Where it is required to be filed, that system automatically identifies, we are given the logic, okay, and then only form 311 appears over there. You can go through the trade circular issued by the department for that purpose.
Yes, sir. The other aspect of it is after passing assessment order, we can file rectification application. We can go in appeal or we can file rectification application. So for rectification application is concerned, in that section 24, there is a provision which says that there is automatic stay. So is there any online module available for filing rectification application whereby our stay will come into play?
As I shown you earlier, whenever the any order is passed on SAP system, when you search that order, three tabs appears over there. One is for appeal filing and part payment, second is for rectification, and third is for payment, regular payment, if you want to pay the order dues directly. So that rectification tab is particularly for online filing of rectification application. Already online rectification applications are filed by the dealers, though the number is very less, because many many a times dealers are filing this manual rectification to the assessing officers also. But all online filing of rectification application is available on the portal.
So stay is automatic in that case, right?
You need to talk on these two rectification module and other people.
Okay, fine. It will be our request that the stay should be automatic in case of rectification till the time disposal of rectification, because this is as per provision of VAT Act. Then. Then what about the restoration? Suppose any of the appellate authority rejects my appeal for want of or some shortcomings in the appeal. Then in that case, I have to file restoration application within 30 days. What about that?
You can file that restoration application on system also. You can search that same procedure is there. You can search that order. You can that rectification application tab appears over there. All these screenshot of this particular thing and flowcharts already given in the appeal manual. If you find any issues in that appeal manual, I am again requesting to bring to my notice. If you find any gaps in that appeal manual, we'll correct that appeal manual. But in my presentation also, I had particularly showed third slide that what are the different kind of applications the dealers can file on system. It is the rectification, restoration applications again, appeal dismissal or restoration application against summary rejection can be filed on system only.
Okay, sir. You mean to say that facility is available?
Yeah. Available.
There's one important aspect of online filing which some of the members brought to our notice is that the appellate officers are requesting to submit manual appeal memos after filing online appeal. Is it necessary that we have to submit manual appeals to the appellate authorities after filing online appeal?
No, it is not expected. If any officer is insisting that, I will talk to Below Liquor sir on this and we'll issue the administrative guidelines in that respect.
It is specifically happening in Kolhapur that has come to our knowledge.
So, but we'll give instruction to all the appellate officer irrespective of the place to which this particular thing is happening.
Yes. The one more query which I would like to ask you is it going to be the online hearing or the hearing will be recorded real time?
It is proposed. It is being discussed that virtual hearing mechanism is required to be devised, but that is very that discussion is very at raw stage, but we are slowly but steadily moving towards that, and as and when it is available online virtual hearing, it will obviously will be communicated to all of you.
Okay, sir. My last one or two queries. Last is about ad interim stay. Once I file appeal, there has to be ad interim stay. If the final stay is not given, what about the ad interim stay? Will I be given auto
stay? Ad interim stay is now applicable only for the orders which are passed before 15-4-2017, right? As per the new amendment, after 15-4-2017, there is no requirement for ad interim stay. So system automatically, as I told you earlier, takes the part payment amount and it stays the remaining disputed amount, and the
operator
is required to file the final stay offer.
Great. It means there is an automatic stay if 10% is paid.
Add interim stay is applicable, available in the drop down of the appeal screen where the assessment order is passed before 15/4/2017.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. And there are, I can see there are few hands raised. Janak Vaghani and Ashwin Tanna, for a long time they are waiting to say something. May I request our convener, Mr. Vinod Maske, to unmute Mr. Janak Vaghani.
Dinesh, Mr. Atul Kulkarni is also waiting at Pune.
Yeah, let Atul Kulkarni speak first, and then Mr. Janak Vaghani and Ashwin Tanna. We have only
Janak bhai, please. Hello. Janak bhai.
अरे जनक भाई नसतील तर अतुल कुलकर्णी ना बोलायला द्या.
ठीक आहे, वन्स.
ओके सर.
कुलकर्णी साहेब, हां बोला.
हां कुलकर्णी साहेब, बोला.
व्हाट अबाउट सर असेसमेंट ऑर्डर पास्ड ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन पीरियड विथ यूज डिमांड एंड फाइनल हियरिंग, व्हाट कैन बी डन इन दैट केस? इज इट नेसेसरी टू मेक द पार्ट पेमेंट?
दिनेश जींनी जसं सांगितलं, त्यांनी रिप्रेझेंटेशन दिलेलं आहे. So that is the policy call, Kulkarni Sahib, and it is you need to follow it up with the commissioner office.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Janak bhai, please. Janak bhai, aaye baga. Janak bhai.
मैं मैंने issue दे दिया मैंने सब. Hello.
Okay.
हाँ दे दिया
ना. I gave all this is nothing and
okay.
Janak ji, namaste.
Rajat bhai is there. Rajat Talati, Mr. Rajat Talati is there. Can you please unmute Mr. Rajat Talati if he is there?
Sir, Sindhya sahab, ek baat tha, Sindhya sahab.
Haan, Janak ji, boliye.
So when I make the full payment of the assessment order, toh form and number 300
mein paid after... Janak bhai has left, I think, sir. Rajat Talati sahab nahi hai,
sir. Sir, wo form number 310 mein paid after assessment ka button click nahi ho raha hai, sir.
Janak ji, again I am telling you, if you have paid that amounts before appeal application.
Are full payment, sir. Full as
full payment, whatever part payment or full payment. You don't want to pay that amount along with the appeal application, right?
Yeah.
So you can directly take that appeal application manually to the appellate officer. We have instructed to the appellate officer that in this particular remote cases, you can take the appeal application manually. But I am again requesting all the, on this, this is the better forum again to request all the esteemed member of the association and all the officials, ki if you want to file the appeal, please go through the appeal application and part payment option, please.
Sir, but mujhe zyada payment karne ka to option nahi aa raha hai na sir wahan pe. You wanted 10%, but I want to make
auto,
more.
Auto stay mein aapko full payment karne ka option aata hai na, Janak ji?
Acha, full payment karne ka bhi auto stay
mein aata hai. Bilkul aata hai.
I could not generate the channel. That was one of the case.
You can show that case to me.
I will show it to you, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, do we have time to take up the oral queries?
Arun Bhayati from Kolhapur want to talk.
Okay, Arun Bhayati, let Arun, Mr. Arun Bhayati speak.
Sir, mi thoda late add zalo, pan mala fakt evadas query aahe yachat. Jeva appeal model madhe jeva apan payment karayla jato teva te payment already tumcha mhanje appeal dakhal karatana actually vakil kiwa CA log appeal submit karat astat. No doubt. तो डीलरचा पोर्टलवर डीलरच्या पोर्टलवरती ऍड होऊन करतो. त्या ह्याच्यात बेसिक अडचण फक्त ऑफिसियल एरिया म्हणा किंवा सगळ्या नाही तसं याच्या संदर्भात मला काही बोलायचं नाही, परंतु पेमेंटची अमाऊंट जी आहे ती जर समजा व्यापाऱ्यांनी जर आधी भरली तर ती इथं काउंट होत नाही. ती रिक्वायर्ड टू पे अलॉंग विथ दिस अपील. तर आता इश्यू एवढा आहे की जर समजा व्यापाऱ्यांनी जर पेमेंट आधी करून ठेवलेला असेल, जसं आपल्या प्रोफेशन टॅक्स मध्ये सुद्धा तो एक ऍक्सेस आहे, जर समजा पेमेंट मी जर करून ठेवलेला असेल तर दॅट कॅन बी करेक्टेड. तो त्याच पर्टिक्युलर ह्याच्यासाठी घेऊ शकते. या टाइपचं जर मॉडेल ओपन झालं तर
बरं. आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू गो इन टू प्रोव्हिजन ऑफ प्रोफेशन टॅक्स ऍज पर एज व्हॅट प्रोव्हिजन आर कन्सर्न. इफ द पेमेंट इज मेड, if the isolated payment is made, that payment is adjusted as per section 40 and it is difficult to take that payment with the appeal application. That's what I'm again And again, requesting you to pay the amount along with the appeal application. In the GST appeal also, you can see that the payment is required to be made along with the APL 01.
Sir, GST cha payment madhe hi ek provision mai already available ahe ki jar samjha tumhi paise bharlele asle tar te cash madhun kiwa credit ledger madhun option
select karte bilkul
ma sir tasa option
kashi aaple system
tyache paise bharlele
tashi aaple tasa ledger तसं लेजर आपल्या सिस्टीम मध्ये अवेलेबल नाहीये. पण अगेन आय एम टेलिंग यू, जर असे आयसोलेटेड केस मध्ये जर आधी पेमेंट झालेलं असेल तर ते मॅन्युअली तुम्ही डीलर ऑफिसर कडे फाईल करून घेऊ शकता. ते
नाही सर, आयसोलेटेड पेमेंट झालेलं नाहीये. फक्त काय आहे की ह्या टाइपच्या मॉडेलमुळे अपील दाखल करताना रिस्ट्रिक्शन येतात आम्हाला.
तुम्हाला सांगितलं ना, सेव्ह केल्यानंतर ऍप्लिकेशन सेव्ह केल्यानंतर डीलरला ते ऍप्लिकेशन ऍक्सेस करता येतं आणि ते पुढचं पेमेंट करता येतं. जर तुमच्या एखाद्या केस मध्ये सेव्ह केल्यानंतर जर टेबल मध्ये व्हॅल्यू सेव्ह झालेल्या नसतील, यू जस्ट शो मी दॅट पर्टिक्युलर केस. ओके, विल ट्राय टू करेक्ट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर मेकॅनिझम. बट ऍज पर
सर हिअर विच कम्स टू माय माइंड इज दॅट कॅन बी मेक सम चेंजेस इन दी मॉड्यूल वेअर इन द पेमेंट कॅन बी ऍडेड. पेमेंट चलन्स कॅन बी ऍडेड ऑर अपलोडेड.
We had already explored that option, Dinesh ji. Payment challan, once you file the payment challan outside the appeal module, it is adjusted as per the provision of section 40. So that already adjusted challan cannot be readjusted against the disputed amount payment. That is the main problem. So again, I am just requesting you keep, there is option available along with the appeal payment along with the appeal application. If there is option available to save the appeal application, if there is option available to again re-login and to process the appeal application for further payment, then there is no requirement for that particular thing.
Pradeep Kshatriya sir, please.
Thank you, Viral.
Go ahead. I will request Viral to take up Kunal Rauda after Kshatriya.
Okay.
As far as system is concerned, module is concerned, it is... there are certain limitations, there are certain constraints which we also face while development of the module. It is not like that we don't want to give the credit of whatever amount paid earlier, but there are certain technical limitations which we also face, and accordingly while designing the module we have to come across all these things, and the ease of use and betterment of that particular thing we had designed accordingly. Okay. Even during one of the service sale meeting, I came up with the requirement of one particular.
Sir, you are not audible. You know what happened?
It's ours.
आवाज गेला त्यांचा. आहेत की नाही ते मीटिंग मधून गेले?
आहेत ना.
एक्झिट झाले
नाही. नाही नाही नाही, माईक चालू नाही. ऑडिओ चालू. शिंदे साहेब,
राहुल टक्कर याच्यानंतर क्षत्रिय साहेब, कुणाल दावडे आणि राहुल टक्कर आणि रजत तलाठी असतील तर रजत तलाठी, देन वी विल एंड द सेशन.
Okay. I want, can I take this question out of turn, please? I have some other meeting to attend. Sorry to have asked out of turn.
Yes, sir. But Mr. Shinde is not available. I think he has somehow exited from the meeting. Can you, Vinod, please check in the waiting room whether he is there?
Dinesh ji, yes, I tell you, my question is little peculiar. Because now automatically the system takes the date of service as per SAP as the date of service. Now physical date could be little later. Now I file the appeal. There will be condonation. Two question: will the appeal get filed? If yes, subject to the condonation getting approved by the appellate officer at a later date, and will the stay get generated on the system? Because nowadays. Stay is also equally important.
नाही, तुम्ही लॉग इन करा ना. तुम्ही रजत सर, वेट, शिंदे सर, तुम्ही लॉग इन करा ना. तुमचं मला वाटतं एक्झिट. Hello. Rajat sir.
Hello. Yes. Yes.
Sorry. Shinde sir has exited from the meeting. He is coming again. Vinod, please see to it that he will be admitted in the meeting. Sir, you carry on your queries.
The issue is this. On
or we, will you please wait for a minute that he is coming in the meeting?
Yeah,
ask him directly.
At 2 o'clock, I need to be on air. That is the next difficulty. Yeah. 4 minutes I have.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Dilesh, I think we shall demand for a dedicated email ID for the appeals.
You request him for that. You request him for that at the end. Or else we can collect the queries from members, and someone from us amongst us will have to compile those queries and analyze them.
Because some of the queries are received for the errors they are getting while uploading the appeal, they making the payments.
Okay, we'll discuss later on this. Vinod.
Another point is that the dealer doesn't have the online payment facility. They go through bank.
अरे तन्ना ये उधर तरी आदि आले नहीं येते. अरे रजत भाई will ask the queries. We will compile our queries and representation. Now let us not ask more queries. Let few people who are there waiting for asking queries. Let them ask and then we will come to an end. विनोद आले का?
Hi Dinesh, na aale tel.
Okay. Ah, okay. Who are calling?
Aale, aale, aale.
Shinde sahib aale?
Oh, he is joining. Vinod, admit kele se tha na?
Oh, zale, zale sir, yeah.
Rajat bhai.
Good afternoon, Shinde sir. It was a really interesting session. One point, you had mentioned that SAP will take the date of service or communication as the date of uploading of the SAP order on the system and migration to the appeal module. Now, two questions. There will be cases where there will be physical service of order at a later date. So we have gone by that date and there will be some condonation of delay. So the issue is, during such period of condonation, would the appeal get admitted and final stay issued on the system, or will I have to ensure that the appellate officer just passed the...
Unfortunately, I lost my connection shortly. So I didn't get you what your exact query is.
Sorry sir. Carry on. There was a little disconnect here at my end.
You please continue, Rajat ji. Please repeat the query.
See, question is, in a case of delay of filing the appeal, delay condonation, would the appeal get admitted and final stay issued now, or will you be have to wait for the appellate officer to condone the delay and then the appeal appeal stay will be granted? What is the procedure?
The appellate officer are instructed to delay the condonation order without any compounding fee wherever this appeal application is being filed lately due to the particular reason of lockdown. They will not require to charge the compounding fees for that. They will have to accept the delay condonation order and immediately issue the final stay order.
Sir, but issue is, today when I upload the appeal, I will also have to, will my appeal get uploaded and will the automatic stay granted to me?
Your appeal will uploaded as like any other appeal before lockdown.
All right. And the stay will also be granted?
System stays that recovery until the final stay order is issued.
All right, wonderful.
And then after it is confirmed by the officer that system stay is properly done. Okay.
So that means, what a little practical question is, so today there is a condonation. Will the appellate officer have to pass the condonation delay order and then the...
They will pass the delay condonation order and also final stay order.
Okay, so final stay will but the recovery will get straight till the appeal is the condonation is
yes. I already explained that earlier.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Deep Kshatriya sahib, Nashik Varun.
My query is this. In my assessment order passed during the lockdown period, due to which heavy demand has been raised. Few points are can be rectifiable, but the few points I have to no other alternative than to file an appeal. Because of the rectifiable points, a huge demand setting, then what is the course of action available to me? In my opinion, first I have to apply for rectification, get that wrong demand reduced and actual. Then after passing of the rectification order, then I have to file appeal against the original order. So whether it is possible against on this module?
No, once the rectification order is passed, the officer is expected to deal with all the original issues raised in the original assessment order, as well as the issues you have highlighted to him in your rectification application. Once the rectification order is passed, you have to file the appeal against this rectification order, because system automatically updates that original assessment order with the rectification order.
Okay.
Say for example, in the original assessment order, 1 lakh rupees demand has been created. You have filed the rectification application with the assessing officer. You have get that demand reduced up to 60,000 rupees. So okay. When you file the appeal against this rectification order and you challenge this 60,000 rupees as disputed dues, obviously your part payment will be determined as per the 60,000 rupees, not as per the original 1 lakh rupees. So I have request you to file the appeal against this rectification order.
But I can dispute in appeal the points in the original order also. No issue on that.
There is no limitation to for the issues to be disputed in appeal, na?
Okay. Thank you very much.
Rahul Thakkar, please. You can raise the query.
Sir, I just have one query, rather not even a query. You were mentioning that the circular number 70 has given that instructions to the officers for allowing the delay condonations without any composite fee. I have gone through that 70 of 2020. Nowhere says so. So it also refers to an internal circular 4A, which is not available on this on the MAGST website.
That internal circular is only meant for this assessing officers.
No problem. So the point which you were making is that there is a clarification or instructions given to the assessing officer or appeal officers that delay condonation application has to be accepted. That instructions is not there in public domain. I mean, if it is internal to the department, I'm not saying that it may be shared.
Okay, I will let us do one thing on this, Rahul. I will go through that 70, the content of that 70 again. If it is not covered, then we'll issue a corrigendum for that, or we'll issue the internal instruction to the
appeal officer. Thank you.
Kunal Dauda, please.
Okay, Kunal Dauda.
Shinde, sir. Nice presentation. Just one point. After filing the appeal successfully, the dealer is receiving the mail for preliminary hearing. And this for preliminary hearing to verify all the documents to appear on the same date on which the acknowledgement is
released. I have come across this issue earlier also. I have asked NI2 to change that logic, and it will be done as soon as this lockdown period will be over.
Okay, so we'll be giving an.
I know that issue. Yeah.
Thank you.
Lastly, Mr. Jagdish Sharma.
Jagdish Sharma, yeah.
Is he there? Jagdish Sharma is not there, I think.
So now we conclude.
Then let us come into the end of the this session.
A brief certain issue points I need to communicate to you all. This appeal module was identified as one of the biggest and one of the complex module as far as this SAP structure is concerned, because it is integrated, it is linked with many other modules. We had a challenge of covering the assessment orders which are being passed on SAP module, and also the assessment orders which are not passed on SAP module. So that orders which are not passed on SAP module also categorized into the two categories of order, which are passed on Mahavikas system and which are passed physically. So it would have been very easy for us to design a simple module to cater the online appeals for SAP passed orders. But we tried to cover those orders which are not passed on SAP. That is why it took a bit long time for development of this module. Also, that this appeal module has got dependencies on others module, as I explained to you earlier, in assessment, in recovery module, in payment module. Recovery module is also expected to go live on in a month or so. As and when that recovery module will go live, you can see your overall status of the recovery at single window. Okay, so whatever the, if say example of particular dealer, whatever the assessment orders, whether it is short filer, non-filer, or statutory orders, whatever recovery is available or not available, all the status of the recovery against that particular dealer will be available on single screen only. So it will bring more clarity, more transparency from part of the department. If a particular dealer is filing the appeals, or say if he is not filing the appeals, what is the status of recovery? Everything will be available on the system also. So you will immediately and automatically will come to know what is the status of the recovery through that recovery module tab also. So, but it will take a month or so for that thing to happen. But I need to just conclude that this module has been designed considering the limitations, considering the constraints, considering the various categories of the dealer which are going to use this module. Try to make it as much as user friendly as possible. I am again requesting you to go through the appeal manual once again. If there are any issues, if there are any gaps in that manual, you can bring to the notice of me. We'll correct that manual and we'll again re-upload it. Okay. My team must have taken certain issues which need to be decided on policy level. We'll discuss that things with commissioner office also. Also, we'll try to frame the FAQs for the common issues faced by the dealer. I am already in receipt of certain issues which I already escalated to concern authorities. So certain new issues are also now communicated to me in today's this seminar. So we'll encompass all these issues and try to frame the FAQs, and we'll publish on the website. Over to you, Dinesh.
Thank you so much, sir. One of our very active member from outstation Amravati. He wants to speak something. I will request him to be very brief, and I will request Vinod to please unmute him. Otherwise, how he will speak? He has raised his hand for a long time. Vinod? Sir, Kushlani, sir, can you please unmute Mr. Jagdish?
Vinod, karte hai iski bhi?
Karte hai bhi. Yes, Jagdish Sharma. Yes.
Sharma sir, boliye.
Sharma sir, please speak. Unmute kar diya aapko.
Tencha end la pun tenna kela pahije na unmute.
Nahi kya yes.
Sir, ek request ho di.
Sharma sahab, aapko hum Shinde sahab ka number denge, aap baat kar lo baad mein.
Okay.
शर्मा साहब
आप बोल रहे हैं पर आवाज बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही है हम लोग को.
नहीं आवाज बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही है सर।
दिनेश जी
बाद में वन टू वन कर लेंगे उनके साथ, चलिए
त्यांना नंबर द्या, त्यांना कॉल करू द्या
नंतर। शर्मा साहब ऑल्सो शिंदे सर हैज सेड दैट ही विल स्पीक टू यू।
दिनेश जी वन मोर थिंग
यस यस यस
माय को मॉड्यूल लीडर्स मिस्टर सुनील भोसले एंड मिस्टर अजय कळंबे इज ऑल्सो देयर, दे हैव ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्युटेड अ लॉट while development of this model. And also Mr. Irlekar from Mahavikas, Assistant Commissioner Mr. Irlekar from Mahavikas is also there. He must have also taken certain issues which you all are facing in the production. We'll try to consolidate that issues also. Okay.
We thank you all, sir. All the departmental officers, we thanks a lot. There were requests from members while we were the session was going on that PPT should be made available and all those. I inform all of you that this video, the record of this session will be available on the YouTube channel of GSTPM. Other thing which I have to note here is that this virtual mega guidance cell has been possible because of this team which you can see in my background. The GSTPM's managing committee, the whole team has worked for it, and specifically I would recognize the names of the chairman of the mega guidance committee, Mr. Sunil Khuslani, who took a lot of efforts to make it possible, Mr. Vinod Maske, who has made this online platform available and operated it, both the conveners Mr. Sunil Joshi and Premal Gandhi, both have worked hard for this mega guidance cell, jotting down the queries and compiling. Further, I will give them a work of compiling the points for representation. I will request Mr. Sunil Joshi, Premal Gandhi and Vinod Maske to prepare a draft representation and get it finalized with our convener, Mr. Aditya Surte. And then thereafter, we will submit that to the department, the commissioner office. Now, coming to departmental officials who are present here, along with Mr. Devendra Shinde, I thank all of them. I thank Shinde sir for this nice presentation and making yourself available for us. And he is available for us whenever we call him for the queries. And he is very efficient, young, energetic and efficient officer we have got in the GST, state GST department. You all must have observed or seen that he was ready to make payment, online payment to show us demo. but sir, the department's technical glitch saved your money.
See, so, Dinesh ji, I have already made online payment through my credit card number of times when the system goes in production. Okay, for testing.
hope government would have reimbursed you. Yeah, but this system related glitch is there, which is noted by sir, and we hope that department will take note of it. There are several. Similar glitches are there, but this is a commendable job done by the departmental officials to make available this online appeal module. And as admitted by Shinde sir, that it requires further development or the corrections or improvement, and they are open for it, which he has accepted. Further, which I would like to mention here is that there is some training required by the assessing officers who pass the assessment orders, that they sometimes pass manual orders, and because of mistakes done by them, we cannot file appeals in the online modules. So proper training is required to be given to the assessing officers, those who pass the assessment orders. Then, as I mentioned, and Mr. Rajat Talati raised the issue regarding date of service of assessment order. That date of service of assessment order should not be auto-filled, which is an ideal, I would say, scenario, because that is further the part of appellate authorities proceeding to see whether the appeal is filed in time or not. So this was the difference of opinion between Shinde Saheb and me. Let us represent this aspect. Then I'm really thankful to Shinde Saheb for being so open-minded to accept our points or the problems we pointed out to him, and he's open for the corrections in the online system. With this, I request our treasurer, Mr. Alok Mehta, who is there in this online mega guidance cell, to propose hearty vote of thanks to Shinde sir and all the other officers, as well as to Mr. Shaligram Sahib, who is as good as commissioner to us, to propose hearty vote of thanks to all of them. Thank you so much. And I request, before that, I request all of you to send your queries or the issues on the email ID which is provided to you at the time of in the message of mega guidance cell, so that our team will prepare a draft representations and we can take up, consider those issues in our representation. Over to you, Alok. Thank you.
French senior in profession, and French and all members, I think you all must have aware that, or must have seen that, you know, during the lockdown period, GSTPM is the only association taken a lead to carry out many webinars, virtual meeting, and even intensive we are carrying out online. And now today, the virtual mega guidance cell meeting, I think the more than 450 participants were there. And I think this is because of the team GSTPM. We always believe that even though there is a national calamities are there, but we continue to serve our member with the education, and we serve the member with the education, and all our objectives should be achieved and all. And that is that, you know, we request all members to not be fees of GSTPM, kindly make the renewal of the fees. And it is very easy. You can go to our STPM website and make the fees. And also we have the reference, which is mouthpiece of our association. It's also ready. You can book the reference. I think this reference is it's been viewed by many people, even department official. So before 31st of May, you can get the discount also. So please contribute for that and get the benefit of association. I only say that, you know, or to humko aur benefit dete jayenge. Now coming to the today's presentation, I think Devendra Shinde sir has made a excellent presentation, given guidance on this VAT appeal. I think truly amazing, sir. I think you can see that your presentation was so excellent that even chat box are full, saying that, sir, lots of good presentation. So thank you, Devendra sir, for guiding us. And I think our all members have got good knowledge and got a good gain of this filing VAT appeal. And also I'm acknowledging that many queries were there which we have resolved during this presentation, which is required for this mega guidance sale. So today, along with Devendra sir, I think I'm thankful to our Nitin Shaligram sir, evergreen person that always available to listen our queries. I also thankful to Jayant Kanade sir, who was there, and Deputy Commissioner Appeal Thane. I also thankful to Janice Shinde sir, DT SGST, and also co-module leader who worked for you. And lastly, I'm thankful to Commissioner of the SGST, Sanjeev Kumar ji, for giving the task to all of you to share your thoughts to all of us. I also thankful to our all members. I think more than 400 members were present, and they are there, and they listened, they patiently hear this our mega guidance. Thank you all members to contributing and giving us the confidence that we can, you know, again carry out this type of guidance sales. Thank you our chairman, Shri Sunil Kushnani ji of the committee, Vinod Maske, Sunil Joshi and Premal Gandhi for organizing such a mega guidance sale very nicely. Thank you all departmental officers, so that today we feel, even though we have lockdown, but departmental officer and GSTPM are doing much better and all for the benefit of the dealer and all. Thank you all, once again, to all of you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra. Over to you.
Hello.